sideways action, up and down.
Yeah, I want to go vlog, but not me in it.
Watch it, don't pull the skinny down.
See that there?
Right, where are we?
We're at Moto 101 today on a coaching day with a bit of a twist. We've got Olympus Pro, a performance coach that's on hand. So the guys are going to be doing some bits on track. When they're resting off, they're going to get some information from Yanis, put it all together and hopefully leave really happy. Get the line going again. Worked really hard getting all the cones in place and then someone just goes straight through.
My job today is basically educate them more, the riders, and explain them what they need to do as we're coming close now to the off season, and make sure basically that they understand the importance and how they can prepare themselves in order to have a better in season next year. That's it. I don't know.
Yeah, mega.
Yeah, maybe, okay. I don't know.
Right, let's go through just a couple of techniques. So what I want you all to do is, we know the position that we want to be into the corner against that bank. So for me, what happens a lot on jumps is people feel safe in the middle of the track. But if you're landing in the middle of the track with your bike not pointing at the bit that you want, you have to make a turn. Yeah, so you're swerving, some of you. So if you're swerving, you're not flat out generally. You're having to back off a bit to make that adjustment. So if you think about the angle you're taking off, the position you're landing, anything from the landing to where, you know, them white posts are should be a complete ruler straight line. No, like, land off should be that way and then back in the throttle off turn, back on again. It's about being intense. So position your bike at that bank. That's where you want to be. Yeah. Now, two things. Some people would like to land and sit into the seat because it's quite easy to gas sitting down. Because it's a short space, maybe you'll land stood up. But if you want to be able to land with a straight line, absolutely flat out, and I want you to focus on doing that with your knees back if you're standing up, and at your hips here, you've got to really hinge over the bars, yeah? If you're kind of only semi-hinging, you can only really use so much throttle comfortable. As soon as you really get your head over the front of the bars, that's when you can land with a lot of intensity, because the power is trying to push your head backwards. It's trying to get, the bike's trying to go away from you. So if you're starting to push against that a little bit more, you can be more intense on your throttle. A taller rider, you might find that your knees dip a bit, that's fine. But it's about pushing into a force that's going that way. So that's why this section is good, because you've got that intenseness on the landing with the throttle, but then you're going to turn your throttle off, so the position's completely different then. So I want you to go from working on, and this is not just this bit, anywhere really, if you're standing up, really hinge forwards on the gas, but when you feel your throttle's backing off, you've got to think, right, the front of the bike's not good for me anymore, I need to weight the back for them bumps. So you go from this position, like right over the front, and then as you back your throttle off, I want to see you start putting a good bend in your knees, keeping them back, really squatting nice and low into the bike. Because when you're doing your gear change down over the braking bumps there, and we're going to talk about the brakes a bit more in a minute, you're going to start really using your brakes. I want to be like so low and away from the bars with my hands that there's a force pushing me forwards on the brakes, but I'm kind of pushing against that. So then I'm strong for acceleration and I'm a bit stronger for the braking. If you're in a strong position, you do more of it. More gas, more brakes. Does that make sense?
Right, how'd it go?
Yeah, I'm really impressed with the guys. We had a good mixture of abilities, which I always like, the variety. Put in a lot of effort. We had just one rutted corner that I stuck with all day, rather than going on to loads of different stuff. Simplified it. A lot of confidence, a lot of good feedback.
Really liked having Yanis involved. He's helped me a lot with my racing, and he touched on some really key areas for the guys. So all in all, the sun's out, we're happy.
Good session today with Josh. We went over so what we discussed today basically is we learn about how to set goals, how to prioritize your time according basically to your lifestyle, and how to be able to reflect basically on your training so you can be able to improve further. And on top of that as well, we touched base on how to improve during the off season. So what the fundamental things that you need to do in order to improve during the off season.
Yeah, I know, but like most places, 120 quid, here he comes, gobshot.
Just the guy I've been looking for. Go on then, tell me the story.
What?
What happened to your laptop?
Oh, don't.
I've heard about it. Yeah.
Go on, don't be shy.
You've just forked out on that mini bike.
Exactly. That could have been a laptop.
That could have been a laptop. I'll buy it off your
cheek. What happened then?
What, the laptop?
No, the mini bike.
Oh. Who wants a broken laptop?
I couldn't go mad at her because it was for the babby. So basically, she bought these, like, you know, a fidget spinner sort of thing. She bought them, like, suction cup ones that you push onto stuff and the babby can knock them and spin them,
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah.
So she's done that. And obviously, when I've been sat there on the laptop, easy, just push it onto the back. She'll be lying there, she can fiddle with them. And she went to push it on, yeah.
Nice.
But instead of just, oh, it spewed.
Antibiotics, so it makes me feel like death.
If you're not
being sick, you're not
trying
right
to record
some footage for a vlog.
Right?
We were
mid-story
time.
That's why I walked off, because it was going to come out that side, otherwise.
Yeah, that's one of the less dramatic things
you've
done to get on a vlog, to be fair.
Yeah.
Wow.
Anyway. Yeah, and she's gone to push it onto the
sake, on set.
This is work time.
Go on.
So she's gone to push it on to get it to suction it to the back of the screen. But instead of just pushing it on like that, on like the back of the laptop screen,
just drop kicked it on there.
Pinched it round the top and squeezed the actual glass of the screen with the thing. And I was actually getting in the shower, and she comes up and she just came up to the door. And I was like, bollocker. She just thought, like, I've done something really stupid. F sake, here we go, what now? Oh, I've broke the laptop. Oh, putting those push suction things on.
Good job you were stood there naked then to accept the apology there and then.
Yeah. I wish.
Can you still not just get a new screen for it then? Or you just haven't got time?
About 800 quid.
I was going to get a new one.
Apple one. That's what I mean. Apple one, like 800
quid. The amount of cares aren't that bad.
Pro.
Yeah. No, you can get an Air that's got the same, but then you can get an Air with an M2 in it.
I've just bought a f***ing Pro now.
Yeah, don't be f***ing. You don't need a Pro.
Go on, this Jim's good stuff. Not when you're shooting JPEG.
Anyone can do that, can't they?
Just yeah, you might as well take photos of your phone the way that you do it.
No, the M, you can get an Air.
You may as well go and sit outside Macca's with your f***ing Wi-Fi.
It'd be quicker if I went to Macca's.
Bastard. We're right on it.
Oh, I should have done that at the start.
Yeah, write something on it.
Story time with Kelsey.
Yeah, take one.
Take five. Take 101.
Yeah.
I actually bought that for my vlogs and never used it.
That's bad, but I might have to get one of them. You want to go steady doing stuff like that?
Huh?
You want to go steady doing stuff like that?
No. Go and get it out if you like.
Well, nah, I'll do some damage. I'm gonna go get me out of this because you'll moan at me if I don't.
Yes, I will. What, are you filming these, lot? Like?
Yeah, I'll get a little bit, I think. See if anyone else turns up. I'm here now, aren't I?